Welcome to the October edition of the Shadowverse Meta Snapshot. Players of Shadowverse, Champions, Battle, and Watchers of the Anime, rejoice! The long-anticipated expansion featuring cards from the Switch game has arrived in Shadowverse. Not only are cards such as Brilliant Fairy familiar to anime watchers, most of them have also been buffed to make them more suitable for the current meta. Alas, the original cards from the anime and Switch game were designed for Shadowverse back in 2016, and the power levels of the average card in the main game has gone up by a few orders of magnitude. Despite the power-ups each of these cards received, the impact on the meta has been minimal. The Dawn of Calamity functions as an extension of the Renascent Chronicles meta. Most of the common decks currently on ladder were featured in last month's meta snapshot, and in fact, Last Word Shadow continues to remain in Tier 1 despite not utilizing any of the new cards offered from the new expansion. That is not to say that nothing has changed. The Wrath support package has finally brought Blood from the depths of Tier 4 back to Tier 2. In exchange, the loss of support cards from Fortune's Hand has caused Forestcraft to plummet down to Tier 3. New cards such as Angel's Graces, Chrono Witch, Counter Magic, and God of Curses have made their way into various existing archetypes and given them a notable power boost. Before we go into the details, remember to like and subscribe to our Tempo Strategy YouTube channel for the latest decks and strategy content. At the top of this month's meta snapshot sits Spellboost Rune, a deck blessed with two of the greatest additions in Dawn of Calamity, Chrono Witch and Counter Magic. In some ways, Chrono Witch resembles another dimensional witch that gave veteran players nightmares. Combined with Guild Assembly, he can make massive tempo pushes with boards that some decks just cannot answer. The goal of the deck remains the same as in the last expansion: play 7 different spells in order to obtain Elements of Creation from Quadra Magic. The most notable aspect about Spellboost Rune matchup-wise is its widely favored matchup against Mysteria Rune, as Mysteria struggles to handle a 0 play point Chrono Witch combined with Element of Creation or Counter Magic. The addition of Hurricane Golem and Frost Golem made up for the loss of Rooney. The deck is very technical to play, as missing just one card to draw or to banish on a crucial turn can lose you the game, but in the right hands, it can feel unstoppable. The burn output gives it an excellent matchup against Wrathblood, and the capacity to make wide boards allows it to handle sword matchups well. While the deck is extremely unfavored against Spellboost Rune, it generally performs better than Spellboost Rune when facing against the Tier 1 spectrum of decks, giving Mysteria a solid place in the meta. Even after the new expansion, Last Word Shadow is still one of the top tier decks, utilizing none of the new cards introduced in Dawn of Calamity, a testament to the raw power of the deck that has been in Tier 1 for the past few months. Not only is the archetype consistent, but most players already had several months of experience playing the deck. In the current meta, the deck retains its wide range of even matchups, with only a slight weakness against Spellboost Rune. Balansword lost Pompous Summons in the rotation, which caused the deck to be less consistent compared to before, hence the rise of the even more aggressive Rally Sword, utilizing cards such as Radical Gunslinger and Cat Admiral to easily boost its rally count. Instead of slower cards like Frenzied Courtmaster, the deck capitalizes on its rally count through Erica, Loyal Sword Savant, making the deck much more aggressive. Rally Sword not only has a wide range of positive matchups, but it is also the only deck that is clearly favored against the rising star that is Spellboost Rune. Its weakness against Last Word Shadow does hold back the deck from getting higher on the tier list, however. One of the biggest additions in terms of archetype support in the Dawn of Calamity expansion is the Wrath support package. The expansion revamped the entire archetype and made it a force to be reckoned with since the first day of the expansion. No longer stuck in Tier 4, this Tier 2 mid-range deck boasts a strong early game presence and a good amount of draw and heals, coupled with notable late game threats to finish the game. Unfortunately, these decks are not enough to propel the deck further up the food chain, as the deck struggles against the two Runecraft archetypes, especially Mysteria Rune, resulting in one of the most polarized matchups among the popular decks played on ladder. Last Word Shadow is a good deck to climb the ladder with. Not only is it decently quick and reliable, it is a deck that requires no updates, and one that players should already be comfortable with. While slightly unfavored against Spellboost Rune, it still has a wide variety of positive matchups on ladder, and Runecraft players are still divided between Mysteria and Spellboost Rune. The two Runecraft decks, Mysteria and Spellboost, are both worth playing and learning, especially the Spellboost Rune Mirror, where it becomes a very technical matchup. Given that most of the archetypes archetypes have already matured from age, not many changes are expected within the upper echelon of the tier list. Decks such as Last Word Shadow will likely remain the same as always, and Wrath Blood already feels optimized. Rally Sword and Spell Boost can see changes in their composition, and Mysteria Rune may include more ways to work around counter magic. No balance changes are expected in the near future, although Forestcraft can use a bit of help to bring it up to par with the other classes. The popularity of Spell Boost Rune may go up as Mysteria goes down. Conversely, the popularity of Wrath Blood may decrease as it struggles against the popular decks, and we may see more usage of Last Word Shadow and Artifact Portal. The similarities of decks between this expansion and the previous one reminds us of a lesson we have seen multiple times before. While the gold and legendary cards can be powerful, without the proper support of silver and bronze cards, it is difficult for them to single-handedly carry an entire archetype. Perhaps Cygames is being more conservative in this season's meta as we approach the World Grand Prix season. Maybe they prefer a more known and stable meta. Speaking of competitive Shadowverse, our competitive players and meta snapshot contributors will be making their appearances in the Shadowverse Open Contenders Cup this month. SEA will be playing in the SEAO Contenders Cup this weekend. Doolin, Hashira, and our regular content contributor Zones will be playing in the West Contenders Cup the following weekend. Please tune in and cheer for our players and wish them the best of luck. Keep an eye on our website for our series of regular Shadowverse content, including a new series of guides for decks mentioned in this meta snapshot. We'll see you again next month for the next installment.